The Quality Food for Health program is a new initiative that Alberta Innovates BioSolutions has started, and we've pulled together a number of great partners to make sure that we produce new healthy food products for the province, and also to ensure that Albertans remain healthy. We're going to be investing in a whole array of activities, looking at new health products, looking at healthier food reformulations, maybe even new kinds of ingredients that we can ship to the rest of the world, all things to look for a health benefit, but also for the economic opportunities that will be available to Alberta producers and Alberta food processors. We have some great examples, looking at why people buy the food that they buy, looking at the kinds of components and constituents that are in Alberta products, and we have a specific interest in one of the activities, one of the projects that we will fund from David Wishart, who's a professor at the University of Alberta. He was the first scientist to actually publish the human metabolome, all of the different molecules that are within the human body. And what we're asking David to do now is to look at all of the Alberta products that are out there that we address, milk, poultry, beef, fruits, vegetables, canola, pulse crops, and cereals, to tear them apart to give us a very clear assessment of the kinds of micronutrients and other things that are going to be available, and then we will use that to market those products to the rest of the world.
I'm Dr. David Wishart from the University of Alberta. I'm a professor at the Department of Biological Sciences and the Department of Computing Science. I'm also a research officer with the National Institute for Nanotechnology, NRC's institute here at the U of A. So this is a new project that probably is an extension of things that we've been very interested in for the last 4 or 5 years. And that's to try and figure out all of the chemical constituents in our food. And it's not just the additives, but it's actually the amino acids, the sugars, the fats, the carbohydrates. We think that an average food item, whether it's the steak on your plate or the hamburger or hot dog you just ate or the cereal you had for breakfast, may have between 3,000 and 5,000 different compounds. And we'd like to figure out what those are. And there's some obvious ones everyone knows about. They're usually listed on the side of your cereal box, but there's a lot of other ones that are really important for flavor and taste, but also for health. And these are called micronutrients. And we're trying to figure out what those are and how much is in some of the foods, especially in Alberta foods. Ultimately, I think if we could show that this works for Alberta, we'd like to be able to see if we could do it for BC and Saskatchewan and Ontario, and that we could do it for other countries or other states. And that this would be a process that we would now be able to analyze food at the level that we'd hope for, but it would be almost routine. We'll use the web to inform the public. I think that is another goal, which is to make the consumer far more informed, far more knowledgeable about the food they're eating. And they're not just simply following trends or the latest ad or the latest fad about what's good and why it's good. We want to have it grounded in solid science. We want it characterized by high-quality scientific methods. We want to raise the bar not only for our understanding, but also for producers and for consumers. And when it comes to, you know, how we personalize our health, food is about the only thing that we have control over. What we eat and what we don't eat is ultimately the thing that decides whether we get diabetes or heart disease, and it's those lifestyle recommendations that, say, our doctors might make, but ultimately we're the ones that decide and we're the ones that choose. So if it's a more informed public and if it's a more informed industry, I think everyone wins. And so that's what our ultimate goals: more information, higher quality information for everyone.
I'm Jacques Magnan, CEO of Alberta Innovates Health Solutions. Quality Food for Health is a very interesting and important initiative where we've gotten into a partnership with Alberta Innovates BioSolutions to develop more science about food, quality of food, and the impact of food on the health of Albertans. The take-home message is that actually by working together, the Alberta Innovate system can create additional value for Albertans. I mean, we take, in this case, two very important aspects of life in Alberta: agriculture, health, and we bring together to provide value for both sectors. So to me, there's a tremendous opportunity to use these kinds of initiatives to build more and more value added for the province.